Greetings, wonderful people, my name is Ivan, and today I want to show you the system behind procedural generation in Nary. I'll try to strip it down to its base so that you can implement and improve the system in your projects using any game engine. I was too dumb to learn the hard, existing solutions to the random generation problem, so I came up with my own system. It may not be very efficient, but it's extremely simple and suitable for beginners. Obstacles in Nary are made with those simple 32x32 pixels blocks. The block's pivot or origin is set to its center, which is unnecessary, but made further system expansions easier for me. I initially tried to draw each obstacle on its own as a combined sprite. I quickly discarded this idea because I felt like it would multiply the amount of work that needs to be done. I would have to save each obstacle's width in a list, placing enemies would be much harder, and levels simply wouldn't be so random. On top of that, I would need to use pixel perfect collisions because the composite obstacles don't fit the usual square, ellipse, or diamond shapes. Let's now get into the generation itself. Don't be scared by the amount of weird code you will see because most of it is unnecessary for our purposes, and I was pretty dumb when I designed this system, so the code may just look bad. Here is the one object responsible for level generation in Nary. It has the same shape as a block, which makes it easier to understand what is happening. At first, it defines the size of a room. In the loading screen, this block is placed at the starting point of a level. Then it moves to the right with defined spacing, which is equal to a single block's width. When the end of the room is reached, loading screen is destroyed and player is placed into the game scene. This level generation block has a cooldown. When it is on the cooldown, it only places single blocks at its position, and when it's not, it places a composite obstacle. Each time it moves forward, a cooldown is decreased by 1. From the beginning, there is a long cooldown which ensures that the first few seconds of a level are just a one block high plane. The obstacles are saved in a different script which just reacts to your string input with obstacle's name. In this script, I define a behavior that makes a shape that I want. Here's an example of how the stairs would be placed. Level generation block has a cooldown equal to 5. It moves forward 5 times and its cooldown reaches 0. A random obstacle's stairs this time is picked from a list of obstacles for this level. The script counts the width of a base level, which is just one block higher than the normal plane. This layer is then placed in a for loop. The amount of placed blocks, in other words the amount of times you had to move right, is already saved in this loop, its variable I. After the loop ends, you move the level generation object that called this script by a gap multiplied by I. You may as well move the object inside of the loop, but I remember that I had some problems related to that, maybe something about enemy placement in the future. Then the procedure repeats for a layer that has 2 blocks above the ground and 3 blocks above the ground. The next loops use other predefined random widths. Notice that I just put extra lines of code in which only the height of a layer is changed. If you understood what I said a few seconds ago, congratulations, you're ready to make your own procedurally generated runner game. My enhancements to the system include placing spikes, slopes, obstacles on the ceiling, and enemies. The latter two have separate cooldowns, which allows me to place enemies with reasonable intervals and define the width of a swapped gravity region. In a couple of sentences, my level generation system does the following. There is a block that is placed at the starting point of the level. This block moves to the right, using x-axis with defined spacing. While it is moving, if it's not on a cooldown, it places a predefined obstacle and jumps forward, skipping the distance equal to obstacle's width. After that, the cooldown is renewed and the next scene that is placed will be just a one block high plane. I hope that I managed to express my thoughts in a meaningful way and you understood what I meant. If you have any questions, feel free to ask me in the comment section below. If you found this video interesting or entertaining, please hit that subscribe button. That will make me very happy and motivated to make more videos. And I'll see you in the next video. Farewell.